Welcome to Electron Line. Here's another way in which we can look at the van der Waals equation again to get a better feel for it. Here what we're trying to do is we're trying to increase the pressure to 100 times the original pressure to see how that would affect the volume of the gas. Now with an ideal gas where we have PV equals nRT, or small v being V over N, meaning the volume divided by the number of moles, that gives us the volume per mole, or the volume per kilomole in standard units, then we know that in order to increase the pressure to 100 times the original pressure, all we have to do is decrease the volume to 1/100 the original volume. Of course, there might be a change in the temperature as well, but we're ignoring that for now. And now when we go to real gas, what happens? Well, things are a little bit different now, because instead of having pressure, we now have P plus this additional term, A divided by V squared. And so what we can say is, to increase this quantity to 100 times the original pressure, again at one atmosphere, A over V squared can be ignored because it's just a very small percentage of the total pressure. With oxygen, it's only about 0.3%. Then we need to decrease not just V, but V minus B to 1/100 V initial. Now the question is, at 100 atmospheres, how big of a factor is that B? Is that constant? Well, at one atmosphere, B is just 0.14% of the total volume, so we can pretty well ignore it. But at 100 atmosphere, since we have V minus B, we multiply by 100, it's now 14% of V instead of 0.14%, which means that instead of writing V minus B, we can write V minus 14% of V. In other words, B accounts for 14% of the total change in the volume. That means we only need to change the volume by 86% instead of 100%, 100 times the original volume. So in other words, instead of V being 1/100 V initial, it's now only 86% of V have to be equal to 1/100 times V initial, which means that V, the new volume, only has to be reduced to 1/86 the original volume instead of 1/100. The difference, the other 14%, well, that comes from the fact that we have B, which represents the actual volume of the molecules, which becomes significant when the gas is compressed 100 times the original atmosphere. So the other 14% comes from the volume of the molecules themselves taking up part of the volume of the container. And that's how we can understand van der Waals equation.